Hello friends, welcome to Quality Improvement in Math Education Project. Video based PPT presentation 2019. My name is SATISH Rangnathra Langote. My registration number is MTE002. My school name is Sri Saraswati Bhuvan High School Ranjani, Taluka Ghansawangi, District Jalna. My topic of presentation is a set theory and subtopic is a definition of set and types of set. So we have to study this chapter by using a three stage. First stage is observe and explore. So observe the following table and classify as you wish. So there are some objects in this table and you have to classify on your choice, and now see the classification. Student will classify as follows. In the first table, student write some numbers. In a second table, student write alphabets, English alphabet, and in a third table, student will write Marathi alphabet. After classifying this, student have to give a name to each group. So first group, first collection is the collection of numbers. Second is a collection of English alphabet, and third is collection of Marathi alphabet. So student will separate in this way numbers, alphabets and Marathi alphabets. Again observe the following numbers and again classify it. So in this combination, numbers are 1, minus 4, square root of 3, 4 by 3, 12 by 2, 5, square root of 10, 1 by 3, minus 3, minus 9 by 3, square root of 4, 6, 10, root 5, square root of 100, minus 17, 17 by 4, and minus 10. So student will classify by using their previous knowledge. Now classification is as a first group, numbers are 1, 12 by 2, 5, square root of 4, square root of 100, 6 and 10. Second classification, minus 4, minus 3, minus 9 by 3, minus 17, minus 10. Third group, square root of 3, square root of 10, square root of 5. And in a last group, there are two numbers, 4 by 3 and 17 by 4. So student classify the group, and now give the name for each group, and student will give the name as a first group is a group of natural numbers. Second group is a group of integers. Third group is a group of irrational number, and fourth group is a group of a rational number. So in natural number, 12 by 2 is there. So 12 by 2 is means it is a 6. Square root of 4 means it is a 2. Square root of 100 means 10. So all numbers are natural. In a second group, all numbers are negative. So negative integer numbers. In the third group, there are irrational number, and in the fourth group, there are a rational number. Again, observe the following picks and classify it again. So here, there are some shapes with a different color. Now, again, student have to classify it and student will classify as follows. In this way, student can be classified in a two way. One is on the basis of color and on the basis of shape. So here is the classification in a two different way. So collections are collections of green color, collection of pink color, and collection of blue color, or collection of triangle shape, collection of circle shape, and collection of rectangular shape. Again, observe the table. In the table, there are some names. Again, student has to classify all these objects, and student will classify as follows. See the classification. In the first table, objects are January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December. In the second classification, student write Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. And in the third classification, student wrote Jest, Ashad, Shravan, Bhadrapad, and Kartik. So again, student have to give a name for each and every classification. So first group is months of solar year. So we know that there are 12 months in a solar year, namely January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, and November and December. Second, all these are days in a week. So this is a group of collection of days in a week. And in a third classification, there are some months in a Marathi year. Now, with this observation, we can define the set, concept of set. So a collection of well-defined object is a set. So well-defined means what? Well-defined means a clearly marked. Which object should be included in that set is clear. When we write the list of object of any collection, then that list must be same for each and every student, then that collection is said to be a set. If list of collection is different for all person, then the collection is not a set. So apply and evaluate. Identify whether the following collections are set or not. So student will decide whether the given collection is a set or not. So first collection, collection of great people of the world. So here is a collection of great people. So great people means here this word is not clear here. Great means in which field they are great. So here if student list of great people, then here every list is different, list is not unique, so this collection is not a set. A collection of pet animals. So here again, every person has a different pet, different animal as a pet animals. So again, list of collection of pet animal is again different from person to person. So again here, this collection cannot be a set. Third collection, the collection of days in a week beginning with the letter T. So if student write the object of that collection, then every list is the same, because days in a week beginning with the letter T are Tuesday and Thursday, and every person has a unique list That's why this collection is a set. Fourth collection, the collection of all difficult questions in the chapter on a set. Again, here difficult is not clear here, because some example are difficult to one person but not difficult to other person. Means again, list of difficult question is changed here for one to one person, so it cannot be a set. Next collection, the collection of active teachers in the school. So if we stay instead of collection of teachers in the school, then it will be set. But active teachers, so active in what manner? So again here, if I say to student, list the active teacher of our school, then again a list is different for each student, and that's why this list cannot be a set. Next, the collection of all integer more than -3. So here, which object should be included is clear here. Means we have to write in this collection a numbers more than -3, which can be write as -2, -1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. So it is the list is unique here. That's why this collection of all integer more than -3 is a set. Next collection, the collection of all beautiful flower in the park. So again, beautiful is not clear here. That's why the collection of beautiful flowers in the park is not a set. So remember that when we write a list of that collection, and if list is the same for every student, then the collection is a set. Otherwise, it is not a set. Means if the list is different for each and every student, then the collection may not be a set. These are the answers of last question. Now come to another question. State whether the following elements form a set or not. If no, then give a reason. So let us see a first collection, all easy problems in your textbook. So see here, again easy is not clear here, because some examples, some problems are easy for one student but may not be easy for other student. That's why it cannot be a set. Now see the another example, capitals of all countries in Asia. So here this sentence is clear, that's why it is a set. All three sided figures, so we know that all three sided figures are, so again this one is a set. First five counting numbers, so if we write the first five counting numbers, if we write the list, then list will be same for each and every student here. Last 3 days of a week, again it is a same for each and every student. All triangles that is difficult to draw. So see here, again difficult is not difficult in what manner. So triangle difficult to draw, triangle is difficult to draw one person but not difficult to other person. So again this collection cannot be a set. All tasty fruit, again here list of tasty fruit is different for each and every student, because one fruit is tasty for some student but not for all student. So again this cannot be a set. All clever boys of your class, again a clever in what manner. So here word is not clear, that's why list is different here, and so this collection cannot be a set. So in this way we can determine the whether the given collection of objects is a set or not. These are the answers. Now see the types of set. So observe the following question picture and write the set. So here in a picture there is one lion, and we can write the set as K is equal to X such that X is a king of forest. So in this set there is a only one element, which is a lion. Now see here there are two lines, line M and N. A question is what? Write the number of intersecting points of line M and N, and your answer is none. There is no intersecting point of line M and N because these lines are parallel lines. So in this picture there is a book, and a last page number is 289. My question is how many pages in the book, and answer is 289. Now see the picture and give the answer of the question. So how many numbers of drop of water in a sea, and answer is sir, we cannot say, this is uncountable. So now by observing all this picture, can you match the pairs? In a first there are a picture of lion, two parallel lines, there is a book, and there is a picture of water in a sea. And in another group there are some name of a set, finite set, singleton set, infinite set and empty set. So of matches are, so see here, a king of forest. So there is only one king of forest, which is a lion, means in that set there is a single element, that's why this set is known as a singleton set. Then another, there is a pair of parallel line, and parallel line never intersect, that's why there is no intersecting point to any parallel line, and so this set may be empty set. Third picture of a book, so how many pages? So numbers are countable, that's why this one is a finite set. And number of drop of water in a sea are uncountable, that's why it is an infinite set. So in this way this is a perfect match. So with this observation we can define the types of set as follows. Number one, singleton set. A set consisting one and only one element is a singleton set. For example, set of even prime numbers, set of principal of school, set of divisor of 47 other than 1. So see here, set of even prime numbers. So we know that a first prime number is 2, which is even as well as prime. So other than 2 there is no even prime number, means in that set there is a single element, that's why a set of even prime numbers is a singleton set. Set of principal of a school, so we know that every school has a one principal, that's why in this set there is a single element, again this set is a singleton set. A set of divisor of 47 other than 1, so we know that 47 is a prime number, and prime number has only two divisor, 1 and itself. So here set of divisor of 47 other than 1, so which is a 47, again 47 is a singleton set. So second set, empty set. So empty set can be defined as a set does not consist any element is an empty set. So empty set is denoted by a Greek letter phi. Empty set is also known as null set. For example, set of days of a week start from letter P. So there is no day which start from letter P. So the set does not consist any element, that's why it is a empty set. Again, a set of circles having a two center. So we know that a circle has only one center, and we don't get such a circle which having a two center. So again, this set is an empty set. Set of class having a two class teacher. So we know that every class has a single class teacher. So means here there are no elements, or no, there is no such a class having a two class teacher. So again, it is an empty set. Another type, finite set. So finite set can be defined as if a number of elements in a set are limited, countable, then the set is finite set. So in this way, singleton set is also finite set and empty set is also finite set, because singleton is countable and empty set is also countable. That's why both are a finite set. For example, set of all even numbers less than 50. So less than 50 means we can calculate, we can count how many even numbers less than 50. Again, a set of number of students in your class. So this is also number of student or total students in the class is countable. That's why again it is a finite set. Set of English alphabets, we know total alphabets are 26. So again, this one is a finite set. And now finally, infinite set. If a set is not finite, then it is an infinite set. Means a object of any set are uncountable, then the set is infinite set. So all set of all numbers, natural number, whole numbers, integer, rational numbers, all are the types of infinite set. Again, one more example is there, a set of stars in the sky. So we cannot count how many stars in the sky. So these are uncountable. So this is also example of infinite set. So now apply and evaluate. A question is, identify the types of following set. So first set A, Y is the Prime Minister of India. So this one is a singleton set, because every country has a single Prime Minister. Another set B, X is a number greater than minus 5 and X belong to I. So there are infinite numbers greater than minus 5. So it is an infinite set. Z, such that Z is a number of person living in a house. So number of person in a house are countable. So it is a finite set. In a set D, there is an equation 2P minus 3 is equal to 0. And we know that every linear equation in one variable has a one solution, unique solution. So here value of P is a 3 by 2, but here P is a natural number. So solution of this equation is not in a natural number. That's why this set is an empty set. Next set E is equal to R, such that R is equal to a square root of 49. And we know that there are two square roots for any number. One is a positive and another is negative. So here value of R is plus 7 and minus 7. So there are two elements, means countable. So it is a finite set. Now F is equal to B, such that B is odd number divisible by 2. So this is impossible thing, because odd number never divisible by 2. So it is an again empty set. In a set G, there is an identity, and we know that there are infinite solution of variable in identity. So their value of X are infinite. So this is an infinite set. Last set D is a number of seed in a seedless mango, and we know that there is a single seed in a mango. if the mango is seedless. So number of seeds in a So last set, H D is a such that D is number of seed in a seedless mango. So this is an again empty set, means there is no seed in a mango. So answers are answers of the questions. So thanks to Mr. Inder Kirana sir and all team of IIT Bombay. Thank you sir. Thank you very much.